notice the barber beater in its natural habitat. Right here, we see it trying to attract a mate by slowing down music and applying reverb.
Barber beats continued to grow and develop. Many other new artists began to join in the fray. Artists like Godspeed Sound, Gore, Snowpoint Lounge, Slower Pace, Manila Ice, now Giovanni Scorpio, Opal Vessel, Mabisio, Memoria Occulta, May Kretsch, Esotericism, Pyroglyphics, Eliminate, Dudette Division, Obsidian Diction, Catascopos, I don't know if I said that properly, but you get it. Digital Jockey, Telehealth, Middle Management, Mail, Vanitas, Palundra, Midnight Premiere, Alexandra, Kratzwerk, Sinners Club, Anosmia, Vintash, Sky is Stumbling, Requiem, Supercuts, Maid Dresses, and Your Discovery. Again, there are undoubtedly more, but these are the ones that are known to me. Many of these artists would come to be known to the masses through a YouTube channel called Rabbit Hole Club, which, without having existed in the first place, I truly believe that Barber Beats would not exist as it is today. There are several other outlets, but I'm going to mostly be focusing on Rabbit Hole Club, as that was my introduction to many of the artists that are well known now in the scene. Rabbit Hole Club would also be my ticket into the genre, and if it weren't for them, I don't think I would be very well known either. I'd like to talk a little bit about my own project, Undersaken. And I know what you're thinking. You're going to interview yourself? Really, dude? To which I will say, yeah, why not? I'm a part of this contemporary movement, why wouldn't I? I have things to talk about from my own perspectives as well. Between the many people in the vaporwave scene, whether it be on Twitter or Reddit, constantly whining and griping about barber beats, spouting off about how it's simply just plagiarism and petty thievery, or Gods of Something's occasional meltdowns, there is obviously a huge stigma and toxicity surrounding the genre because of its heavy use of sampling. Besides all that nonsense, I want to try and encapsulate what it is truly that makes me want to create this genre, why I actually think it's extremely meaningful, and why I think it transcends other forms of artistic expression. Picture yourself surfing the vast open net, the many horizons of all the things that ever were, searching through an endless, infinite plane of existence for that perfect sample, or that captivating image, tirelessly and patiently awaiting that moment of blissful satisfaction, that sweet release, that moment where you, yourself, feel a thrilling spark or shock of inspiration rushing over you. The unexpected, fleeting glimpse of true euphoria, or hearing a track that awakens you and makes you feel glad to be alive. You feel shivers, good shivers. You feel great, the dopamine, the serotonin. But more importantly, the pain. It dissipates, even for a moment, the pain of being alive, and the solace you get from that sweet release from it, taking over your mind and your body, making you forget the monotony of society and everyday life. I'm sure we all have different takes on it, but the experience of art, the true essence of what it does to us, and how it affects our lives. That is unabashedly one of the most powerful parts of being human. I want to share that. I want others to have that feeling. I want everyone to experience what I experience, even if it's not exactly the same experience to them, or even if it doesn't resonate with them. I just want to see if others will appreciate the experience like I do. And I'm telling you right now, when they do, when they connect with me on that level, that's why I do it. And maybe you don't understand what I'm trying to say, and that's all right. I don't need you to understand anything at all, except that I definitely don't do this for credit, profit, or any other malicious reason. I do it to express myself, and I do it for those wonderful feelings that I mentioned, and I do it to connect with people. That's it. That's why I love Barber Beats. That's why I make Barber Beats. Now, besides my cringy self-insert, I have some other excellent artists who will share their viewpoints as well. I hope you enjoy. First up are three of my biggest influences: Godspeed Sound, Gore, and Snowpoint Lounge. Followed by some other artists who have also inspired me: Pyroglyphics, Mabisio, and Esotericism. Once again, I won't be reading out these interviews, they're all text-based, but I'll be playing their respective tracks to accompany their interviews. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to Godspeed Sound, Gore, Snowpoint Lounge, Pyroglyphics, Mabisio, and Esotericism for your interviews. This concludes part 2 of the documentary. Thank you for watching.